What is that, y'all? It's your boy. Wow. Hold on. What is that, y'all? It's your boy, Nick. Y'all see what we have here today. Dean Dotson. That boat. You know what I mean? But before we get into that, a word from our sponsor. First of all, I'm going to need y'all to follow me on Twitch at BeautifulXNick. I'm streaming damn near every single day over there, okay? Look, I know the videos haven't been coming out as frequently as possible because I'm sitting up here doing multiple things at multiple times, okay? So bear with me. I'm only one guy, okay? So I'm going to get the videos going. I see y'all subscribing, and I mess with y'all. But go ahead and subscribe to my VOD channel, whatever. BeautifulXNick, if you missed the live streams, which I'm live streaming every single day. Currently right now we're playing No More Heroes 2, and I think I'm almost done with it, by the way. So after that, we're about to get into Reman, and after that I got a lot of other games I'm gonna be playing, and plus we're gonna do a lot of other more things on the live streams, but we're gonna slowly but surely gonna switch to the live streams, to Twitch. So you know what I'm saying, don't get twisted, I'm still gonna be here on YouTube, okay? Don't get twisted, I'm still gonna be out here on YouTube, but you know, low key, I'm really liking Twitch right now, so that's what it is. Second of all, can y'all do me a favor? Just one favor. I don't ask for too much, but can y'all do me a favor? Can y'all follow me on Instagram as well? No, but that's not the favorite. Can y'all do me a favor? There is two channels that I need y'all to follow. Help them out. All right. If anything, I'm gonna be selfish. It is what it is. The links are in the description below. All right. Shout out to my boy Orion Complex. You know what I mean. And my boy Jake. Okay. Help them out. You know what I mean. On some real shit. Like, you know what I mean. Like help them out. You know, one does music. The other one he does play games. But he hasn't posted in a while. And I want to see. You know what I mean. I like to see anybody that supports me. I'm supporting them right back. You know what I mean. And whatever I can do to help them, I'ma do it. You know what I mean? And they've been rocking. They've been with me since my music channel. I know some of y'all have been there too. Okay, but you know what I mean? They got some channels. I want to see some success in them. You know what I mean? That's just me personally. All right, so go show them some. If you see this, click the link down in the description. You know what I mean? Say what's up. Say hi. Subscribe to them. You know what I mean? If you want to. I'm not forcing you to, but just know that, you know, it would be appreciated if you could. I mean, what else is stopping? It's just a little subscription, you know what I mean? And then, you know, watch one video, you know what I mean? That's all I'm asking. You don't got to do that. That's all I'm asking. Let's go visit them. The links are in the description down below. Say hi to them. Yo, what's up? I want to see these boys and anybody else. Like, trust me, I'll do this for anybody. If, like I said, it's just like, bro, come on. We got to support each other during these time of need, okay? Especially for these two, they've been here since the beginning, and I want to see them grow. That's all it is. And I'll do the same thing for you, if you were there for the beginning too. Or you don't even have to be there, but you just come to be humble, you know what I mean? So that's what I want to do, spread some love. But look, what we got here today, Burnout by Gene Dodson. Let's go ahead and click right into it, bro. Yeah, let's get into it, bro. Let's get into this shit.
Dude, being in front of a camera is weird.
Bro, I ain't gonna lie to y'all, man. I did see that he did like a interview or something. With that one dude, with the glasses, I think y'all know him. I forgot his name though. I'm like dead ass. I'm not even trying to be joking or anything. I really dead ass forgot his name. But it starts. Wow, I really forgot his name. I dead ass really forgot his name. But y'all know the guy with the glasses. That he got like a mustache. He's very like, you know, popular person. I saw that interview that he did with him. Low key. Gene seems like a really down-to-earth cool guy, bro. I like that. All right, you know what I mean? I really like that, bro. You know what I mean? I definitely like that. That's why I feel like I fuck with the music and seeing the progress. One thing that if y'all don't know about me is like I like to see the behind the scenes type of stuff. You know what I mean? I like to see that what goes into the process of certain stuff, because you don't ever know what an artist or whatever, whoever goes, what they do behind the scenes and how they make the things that they make. Because a lot of people ask me, like, when I was, because I still do my music too, don't get twisted. But a lot of people ask me, like, do you do this? Do you do that? What's your process behind this, and the third? And I was like, bro, I just be doing me. So it just be a mood sometimes. And I do that all the time, even with the music that I'm making currently. It'll just be a mood. And, you know, some things, like, you get from aspirations. Like, for me, I know it's weird to say, but not really weird to say, but, like, a lot of my ideas that come from, you know, come from my head, literally come from my dreams, to be honest with you. Like, I have very vivid dreams, like, very, very vivid, very, like, not lucid dreams. Shout out, you know what I mean? Shout out to Jared, but, you know what I mean? Like, very vivid dreams, like, very, very animated movie-esque dreams. Like, I'm talking about, if I was to able to, like, plug in my brain and put it onto a screen and show y'all what I dream, y'all be like, bro, this is a whole movie. It'd be like that every time. I know some people feel the same way too, like, for me, like, but that's where most of my, and I'm a very imaginative dude. That's why I love, like I said, that's why I love anime and cartoons so much, because it makes stuff, you know, it's different from reality, where it's, you can go beyond whatever, you know, beyond the boundaries of, you know, human limitations, you know what I mean? So, that's just me though. But like I said, like, this man right here is a very creative person, you know what I mean? Even down to the album covers and stuff like that. And I love album covers. I'm just saying, like, if you don't have, to me, like, an album cover is literally, like, what sets the tone or the aesthetic for it's literally the first visual to the world that you're trying to bring people into this, like, music, like, into your music. Like, when I see an album, it's like jumping into a different portal, into a different, like, world of that artist, you know what I mean? It's like it's like jumping to a different level. It's like literally like Kingdom Hearts. Like, you're jumping into a different world when it comes to, like, albums. That's why I feel like for certain artists, when they go all out for their when they have more thought process behind their cover art or their visuals and stuff for that specific album, it's like you get into a whole world. You know what I mean? Versus the person that literally makes it, like, 6 to 7 same album covers, and it's like for me, bro, I'm, like, literally jumping back into the same world and shit, like, and then jumping right back out because I'm getting denied, because it's like, bro, there's nothing new here. There's nothing new. It's like, it's literally nothing new here, like, bro. So, you know, it is what it is, but, you know, let's get it.
I don't know if you ever get used to it. I think actors get used to the shit, but, like, it's just kind of weird. Looks like some kind of,
and apparently this nigga, like, tall as hell
thing. I don't know. Anyways, you ever think about the last time you were truly happy?
I don't know.
The sounds, the smells, what everything looked like. The older I get, the harder it becomes to just not think about when I'm happy, because I'm happy more so than when I was younger. When I was younger, I felt like it was great. Everything. High school sucked.
College super sucked.
The older I get, the happier I get. And I think it's the opposite for people. Thankfully, I think it's
no. I feel the same way. Like, I really do feel the same way. The older you get, the happier you get. Cause I ain't gonna lie to you, as a kid, horrible. But the older I get, the more you realize that, you know, life is precious. Life is short. Even though I ain't gonna lie to you, cause I have experienced stuff to where it's like, I did value my life a little bit more, but then again, it was sometimes it wouldn't be always that way, you know what I mean? But the older you get, like I say, the happier you get, the more content you get. I can see why he said it feels like for the opposite, because for the opposite, people really think about the negative stuff about being older, like, you know, paying bills, a lot of bills, taxes, a lot of grown-up stuff, you know, basically where you're gonna live, you know what I mean, this, that, and the third. You gotta get a job, this, that, and the third. I ain't gonna lie to you, like, being constricted to that stuff like that, definitely you'll get a lot depressed. But I feel like for those who be like, you know what, I don't need to do this, and I want to just live the way that I want to live, because there's really no restrictions on how you live. It's just how you view yourself and how you see stuff. Because like I said, I don't compare my life to anybody else's. I don't want to have nobody else's success but my own success. I don't try to sit up here and look at other people and how they're doing, like, on Instagram and stuff. I don't try to compare myself to them, like, you know what I mean? Like, I Because like I said, I feel like to me the slower, the more slower and more like planned out your stuff is, the slower you get to success, you know what I mean, the longer it's gonna take you to peak. Look at LeBron, for instance. You know what I mean? Look at LeBron. He's still, people say he's been peaked, but the man is playing even better than he has been before. And he's 36. Think about that, bro. Think about that. Like a lot of people, you know, you'll look at some of your friends back in high school or whatever, and you'd be like, you'll see what they're doing now. It's like, bro, they definitely peaked. You know what I mean? Like a lot of them peaked in high school. Some of them peaked probably like later on in life. It's like, for me, it's like, I feel like I'm steadily still growing and doing stuff. You know what I mean? I'm doing anything. I'm really doing what I want to do, and I'm enjoying it and I'm loving it. I feel like that's what everybody should be doing. You know what I mean? I know sometimes there's some limitations, but like I said, it's going to be harder. I mean, it's going to be hard, but I feel like the harder something is to obtain, the more enjoyable it's going to get when you get it. You know what I mean? That's the real thing. That's why when you playing a video game on super mega hard, whatever, on very, 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 on a, like the hardest difficulty, and you beat the game, don't you feel more satisfying if you would have played it on child's mode, easy mode? And you just ran through it quickly. You don't get the experience like that, bro. So that's just how I feel, bro. That's just how I feel. I feel like we should all approach life like that sometimes. Like, bro, I mean, not even sometimes, like all the time. I feel like everybody should be like, if you're young right now, sorry about that. If you're young right now, it's never like, bro. Plan your future, but plan your future to a way where you want to do what you want to do. Don't sit up here and listen to your parents or other people telling you that you got to go to college, you got to do this, that, or do that. You don't have to do any of that. It would be a nice plus to. I say college is bad, but I feel like just like me, and like a lot of other people, especially some of your favorite creators or music or artists or whatever, they will all tell you the same thing. They like literally go look at interviews of people or look at your favorite creators and see what they say about how they feel about college now that they're like older and they are done with college. It's literally the same thing. They'll literally give you the same answer. And I noticed that. It's like, bro, like, it, even for me, because I came to that same conclusive answer. For me personally, college was a waste of time. And honestly, it wasted my time to the point where I felt like I could have been doing something that I actually enjoyed and loved doing versus doing something that I was basically wasting my time for and being miserable over. You know what I mean? So plan it correctly to the point where you can. You do what you want to do. If you want to go to college, then go to college. But you don't have to go to college, especially if it's for something that you know that college ain't really going to help you provide for. There's nothing wrong with education, because I will always side with education. But make sure it's education that's going to make it last while for you, something that you go to that's useful for you. I'm just saying, when's the last time you used a quadratic formula? I'll wait. When's the last time you ever had to, count how many neutrons or electrons that are in one molecule? You probably, even in high school, like, bro, even people that just graduated college or graduated high school, you probably don't even remember anything that you learned in biology, physics, whatever. You probably don't remember anything that you learned in there because unless if you are pursuing to be a scientist or whatever degree, like, bro, you like I said, look at this, like, bro, what's the last, bro, when is the last, okay, I ain't gonna say that, because low-key, you know what I mean, language arts is very important, but when are you really, you know what I mean, like, what is the purpose of you learning the history behind some books, you know what I mean, like, that's all I'm saying, bro.
And I think when we're younger, we're forced to do things that we don't understand. That's why I hated school.
Facts.
But school is important. I wasn't good at it. I wasn't popular. I wasn't somebody that everybody liked. And I wanted to be somebody that everybody liked. Everybody does. I don't care who the fuck you are. The older I got, the more anti I got.
I mean, I can see that, but to be honest with you, I'm, and it may sound like this, but I'm being 100% honest. I really don't care if people like me or not. I don't want to be liked. If you're going to like me, you're going to like me for who I am, bro. If I'm not going to change for nobody, not even for my significant other. Hence why I'm single now. No, but also real shit though, like, I'm never gonna change the way that how I wanna be. I never wanted to be like, even in high school, I never really cared to be like. I feel like people just naturally gravitated towards my, like, you know, towards my energy. Even though I hate using that word energy and, like, you know, like all that type of stuff, but like, I feel like people definitely just naturally just gravitated towards a person like me, because I'm just like, I'm a neutral guy. I was never the cool guy in school, nor did I want it to be the cool guy. I was just literally the kid. I was literally the kid that would make people laugh and do my thing, you know what I mean? Do my thing. That's basically, I was basically chilling the whole time in high school. I ain't gonna lie to you. I was that dude. Not like that dude, like I was the popular dude, because I wasn't. By far I wasn't. I was, if anything, I was probably, the people that I hang out with were the least popular people, but I didn't care. I wasn't that type of person to be like, oh, the cool kids are here. Oh, damn, I got to leave my friends so I don't look lame. Like, no, I never was like that, bro. I never was like that. I'm going to hang out whoever the hell I'm going to hang out with. I don't care who you are. I don't care. Unless if you're annoying, because then I'm not hanging out. I don't care. I hate annoying people. I hate annoying people. But like I said, like for me personally, even in high school, like, I didn't even have a specific friend group. I was literally, nigga, I was just friends with everybody. At least that's how I felt like it was. You know what I mean? I was literally friends with anybody. If I didn't even know you, you know what I mean? I don't go out of my way to talk to people. But like I said, even if I didn't know you, like, bro, people would know who I am and stuff like that. And I'm just like, bro, I don't care. I'm cooling, bro. I could give a damn who liked me, who didn't. You know what I mean? I really didn't care, bro. I was just like, I was just that person. I was like, bro, I really didn't even care for school like that. Be honest with you, I never even cared for school like that. 100%, I did not care for school like that, because I didn't really know what direction I was going to really go for. Because there was a lot of things that I could have done. Because it's just like, it's really like that for everybody that goes into school. Like, once you get in junior high, sometimes you got your mindset on, you got to really find out like what you're going to plan on doing for high school so you can advance towards college. And that's what they tell you. For me, and that's like, I didn't know what I was gonna do, because I could have been sometimes there would be some days I wanted to be an engineer, someday I wanted to do something into music, sometimes I wanted to do something into being teacher or something. Like, I didn't know what I wanted to do. And then it come to find out, you know, after high school, it's like, oh damn, I really gotta find out what I wanted to do. And then you have to pick something, because then you have to, because you're listening to the people telling you that you gotta go, you have to go, it's stressful. You have to go to, like, they stress you that you have to go to college. And for me, it's just like, you don't have to go to college unless if you really want to go to college. Even if everybody else in your family has never been to college. Like, I was literally one of the first people in my family that even went to college. Literally. I had got scholarships and offers from actual colleges. I would have been the first, and just like a lot of y'all, I would have been literally the first person in my family to go to college. You know what happened? Well, you know what I did? I went to community college. And then ultimately I just stopped going, because they hold me. But that's a story time for another time. But they hold me. And I was like, bro, I literally just wasted my time. I'm literally sitting up here working to pay for my college, my community college, just to get hoed. I literally paid them niggas for no reason, because I learned nothing new. Like I said, like, I didn't know nothing new. And like I said, I'm like one of those kids, I didn't really care for school, but one thing that I always said to myself is that I like to prove people wrong. And it's funny that I'm saying this, because I had a conversation with somebody with this about the other day. But I like to prove people wrong, because people told me, you know, my whole life, people say, you know, yeah, I may be funny, this, that, and third, but I'm definitely stupid. Slow. Low-key might be an R word, you know what I mean? all that type of stuff. Yes, because I had learning disabilities. Ain't nothing I could do about that. You know what I mean? Ain't nothing I could do about that. I literally had to go to a special ed class. I wasn't even special ed, but they signed me to a special ed class because they thought I was really that slow. You know what I mean? And I'm that type of person, like, bro, I'm not slow. I'm not. And one thing, and this is how it is, and this is how you know people are fake as hell, bro. Because in real life, my motto is all act dumb. Act dumb. Think smart. Let it seep into you for a second, bro. Act dumb and think smart. And you'll see how people change up on you real quick. If people think that you're stupid and they take advantage of you like that, if they think they'll try to, you know, do shit to, like, you know what I mean? If people think you're stupid, they're going to perceive that you're stupid and they're going to lower their guard on you. I think like a finesser, though. I think like a finesser. I know. I'm going to get back to it, but I'm just saying, like, think about it like that. But like I said, I like to prove people wrong. And people, one thing that always irked me, that people thought I was stupid. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to act stupid. But I'm going to prove people wrong. People said that I couldn't take these pre-AP classes, AP classes, and pass those classes. I was too dumb. That's what they said. I ain't gonna even lie to y'all. This was very stupid, and don't ever do this. But I literally, from my, I think it was like my junior year or my sophomore. No, it was literally my freshman year. Like, from freshman to senior year, I had at least one to two AP classes. But I think it was like my junior year. I took nothing but AP classes. I had took nothing but AP classes. Only had like one regular class, and I think that was like I don't even remember. I think it was history, and the history is literally the only one people suggested me that I take AP classes for. But like, I literally took AP classes for everything else, my weakest subjects, and still passed those hoes. Still passed them. And I'll show you how people really thought, because there's high school really teaches you like the difference between fake people and real people, bro. I mean, even in junior high, I ain't even lie to you. Even in junior high, there's a lot of fake ass people in junior high. You little kids be fake as hell sometimes. But like in high school, it'll teach you like from the fake people and real people. Like, you know what I mean? And people hate to see other people win. And it's true. People hate to see other people win. And it's sad. Let me continue.
Not for the sake of being anti or being edgy.
I'm sorry.
Just the older I got, the more I became okay with not being super liked.
Bro, it's gonna be like a 15-minute video. Wait, how long have I been recording?
Now, me being liked or me being paid.
Oh my god, it's already 24 minutes.
It's like an active part of my life.
Okay, I ain't gonna talk no more.
I just don't fully understand it. I think my mom's proud. I don't know if my dad's proud. I don't talk to him that much. I don't have a good relationship with males, especially not male dominant figures. That's why I sucked at sports, because I couldn't listen to anybody.
I feel the same way, bro. It's like literally, this man speaking like he's me. I feel you, bro. I literally feel the same way. But granted, you know what I mean? That's how some of us is born, you know what I mean? Shout out to my mama, you know what I mean? I love my mama, you know what I mean? My dad, don't know you. Don't care. I don't care. Stop it. You know what I mean? I don't care. I don't really fuck with niggas, bro.
I wanted to be good at football, basketball, soccer. The only sport that I'm okay at is boxing, and that's just because I like fighting.
Yeah.
And even that, the older I get,
okay.
The more I sit around.
That boy got some hands on him. He got some hands on him.
Think about shit. You just go outside. The only thing that matters that day is exactly what you're gonna do while you're outside. Drinking from
kids don't go outside no more anymore. They don't go outside no more. They stay inside and play Fortnite all day.
The hose.
Or on TikTok.
Going inside.
Speaking of which, follow me on TikTok.
And then going back outside. The longer we get, the more inside we are. At least I think. I wonder sometimes if our happiness is contingent off of the shit that we're doing actively. A lot of people are just happy doing nothing, like me.
Yeah.
Watching TV, being inside a fucking makeshift studio, making something that people may or may not like. People ask you, how do you become successful? I fucking have no idea what success is.
Facts.
I think being happy more so than not is success, and feeling everything is success, I guess.
Facts.
I had a friend in high school named Mark. He was tight as fuck. He had a hard life. He was the one emo kid that I knew. My Chemical Romance, button up shirt, fucking mascara, the whole deal.
And I always wondered, like, why he was sad all the time.
And not because just being emo means that you're sad. I think kids that were emo were more pensive. And I don't think I was ever that. I could give a fuck less about so much shit, even when I was young. So now, and even more so now, I spend more of my time smiling now. Not only because I get to do what I love, I think, but because I don't give a fuck.
Exactly.
I try not to give a fuck. I still care. I care about you guys watching. If you're watching somewhere, wherever the fuck you're at. I don't know why I care. I don't even know you. I shouldn't. But I want to do something that's bigger than me. And I'm not here. That it means something. That it meant something. Again, this sounds like a fucking suicide letter, but it's not.
Yeah, she yanking the hell out of your head, bro.
I'm just trying to figure out how to keep that happiness going. And how to keep everything that I'm doing to mean something. I think a lot of times it's easy to think of ourselves in simple terms. Think of music in simple terms, but
okay, my boy got a G.
Everything is hyper complicated, but I know the simpler you make things, the easier it is to digest. And sometimes digesting shit fast isn't the best way. Sometimes you want something that's itching your ribs.
Facts. This man speaking nothing but facts right now. I can't do nothing but agree.
I don't know what genre of music I make. Don't ask me. I'm the worst person to ask. You might as well go ask your fucking neighbor that listens to it or something. Because I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing half the time.
I fuck with this nigga so heavy, bro. Like, facts, man. Stop limiting yourself into one thing. Good thing is that I feel like the day and age for people... I don't know. The day and age for people to, like, make the... I don't know what I'm trying to say. Basically, bro, just do whatever you want to do. Just like he said, man, do whatever you want to do. Do what makes you feel happy, bro. Don't sit up here put limitations on yourself, bro. No matter what category you are in. If you feel like one day making music, make music. And then the next day, if you feel like making a video on and putting it on YouTube, do that. If you feel like streaming on Twitch, do that. If you feel like one day, you know what? I just want to cook something and I'm going to film it. Do that. If you want to make a movie, go make a movie. Don't care about the budget or whatever. Like, bro, stop caring. Just do it. Do it. I'm not saying that I do that too. I mean, I do that, but I could do a better job at doing it. You know what I mean? I feel like I could, and this is just speaking for myself. I feel like I could do a better job of just doing whatever the fuck I want to do. You know what I mean? Sometimes you'll get in the back of your mind, you know, sometimes there'll be those thoughts to be like, well, should I really do that? Should I really do this, this, that, and third? You know what I mean? Like, sometimes you get those type of thoughts, you know what I mean? And I get those type of thoughts too, you know what I mean? I always feel like, oh, I have like a second, like, there's a half of me. I know it sounds whatever, cliche, everybody else said that, but I really do feel like there's another version of Nick. There really is. I really do feel like it's been like that. I mean, like, you know what I mean? If people don't know, I'm not gonna really go into detail, but I do have some minor, like, signs small signs of schizophrenia, just a little bit, but it's not very major, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? It ain't to the degree of something else, but like, you know what I mean? Like I do kind of have something like that, you know what I mean? But I don't personally see it as a bad thing, but more so you like sometimes you'll have negative thoughts in your head that sometimes you can't even control, and you don't even want to think those thoughts sometimes. I feel like if you're able to just like overpower it, I don't know how, but find a way to do it, you know what I mean? And then just do whatever you want. It's always like a wall that you just need to break. Just break that wall. Just do whatever the hell you want to do, man. It doesn't matter how long it's, you feel like I said, success is really, honestly, subjective at the end of the day. Because some people measure success based on what they see on Instagram, which is horrible, and you should never do that. I'm sorry. You should never do that. Just because you see somebody having $1 million, like, Wraith or something, or like a G-Wagon, and they have all these expensive clothes and stuff, doesn't mean that they're happy. Doesn't mean that they're successful. They may be successful to your eyes because the amount of money that is equated to that picture that is drawing you in, and you see that, and you say, well, damn, they're living a successful life. Why do you think a lot of these people out here, a lot of these famous people commit suicide and stuff? Why do you think a lot of them are very depressed and not happy? You know what I mean? Just really think about that for a second. You know what I mean? Money, and I know whatever, like I said, once again, I know it's cliche, this, that, and the third, whatever, but it's definitely true. Money does not make anybody happy. It may fuel something to, you know, for a purchase to make you feel happy. It's temporary happiness, but that's not what you should be aiming for. You should aim for longevity. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, that money is literally just a piece of paper that is green, that is dyed green. You know what I mean? You should just be able to live how you want to live. It don't matter. And don't worry about what other people are saying. I don't give a damn if you're still living at your mama's house, at your parents' house, and you feel like you have no sense of direction. Find something that just makes you happy and do it. The money just comes later. I know you got bills to pay, just like we all have bills to pay. But sometimes you just don't really need to worry about it like that. You know what I mean? I don't know how else to explain it. It's just like, you don't really need to worry. Just like, these worries? I don't know, because I'm about to go to a whole nother theory about, you know, that, but that's just my type of thinking, bro. You know what I mean? It is what it is. I'm not going, look.
This I just video know that I care about it. I want the 7-year-old me to be happy about what I'm doing. Aside from these things, which are not tight and not good for you, so don't smoke cigarettes. Please. It's a fucking rabbit hole. I've smoked like 10 today.
For no reason.
I think we build confidence in ourselves by being a little lost. And then when you find what you're looking for, that little thing that you're looking for, that little spark, hold on to that shit. You don't know when it goes away. You don't know when the light dims. I'm just a fucking kid. I'm trying to figure it out just like you. And if you're watching, no matter where you are, just know that I care about you. I may not know your name, I may not know your face, but I do care. And the things that I do are for you. Because when I was younger, I felt like nothing was for me.
Facts.
I wasn't an athlete, I wasn't popular, I wasn't fucking cool. And I wasn't an outsider for the sake of being an outsider. I just wasn't understood by everybody. And that's all right. It's cool to be you. Try stop giving a fuck. It helps a lot.
It really does.
but give a fuck a lot about the things you care about.
Yes.
And it's not advice, because I still don't know what the fuck's going on.
We just all going through the motions, bro.
I just don't know what the fuck's going on better than anybody else. Catch you guys on the next one.
This man didn't even have to make a song. We made a fucking 50-minute video, damn it. And I posted it all, too. Shout out to Gene Dodge, man. He spits real facts, bro. Literally. Just stop giving a fuck sometimes. You know what I mean? Just stop caring sometimes. You know what I mean? But care about the stuff that you want to do. Elevate yourself. Self-help. You know what I mean? Do whatever you want to do. Remember, there is no such thing as a limit on when you can start doing whatever you want to do. There's no age limit to doing. If you like, I don't know why, but if you like 50 and you watching my video, you still got time to do whatever you want to do. If you want to become a music artist, you don't have to be a certain age. This, that, and the third. Whatever people are telling you, or whatever makes you marketable, whatever this, that, and the third. Like that, this, none of that shit doesn't matter. None of that matters. You want to make music and you're like 50 years old, bro, do it. I literally got an ad the other day, no cap. I literally got an ad the other day of this dude that was making, I don't know if this was like one of his first songs or whatever, but that man looked like he was 54 years old. He looked like an OG, you know what I mean? He looked like an OG. Like, he looked like he could be Snoop's age. And he making music. So what's stopping you? You know what I mean? But yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed. Shout out Gene Johnson. This some real shit. You know what I mean? I really fuck with this heavy, bro. He spins some real stuff, man. He really is spinning some real stuff. I really fuck with his. I fuck with his mentality. I feel like a lot of people should have that same type of mentality. You know what I mean? Know that not everybody's perfect. You don't have to be perfect. It's all assimilation at the end of the day. Y'all said I'm about to go into my conspiracy bag. Nah. But bro, just do whatever you want to do, bro. If you just want to be one of those people that just want to go outside and enjoy nature, then just enjoy nature, bro. Stop stressing over stuff that you can't do anything about. You know what I mean? Because you're not gonna be able to do anything about it, bro. But look, I hope y'all enjoyed. I love y'all. I'm out, DB. I'm down! It ain't that long, but, you know. This had to be said, bro. This had to be said. He's been so, like I said, I don't know. I can't really form stuff, you know, properly out of my head, like I told y'all. Like, you know what I mean? But I told y'all some stuff that y'all probably didn't know about me. But I don't care. Know that I love y'all. Like I said, when I tell y'all, I love y'all. I really do. Cause y'all don't know what y'all be doing to change a nigga life. I know some of y'all get upset when you know people say damn where did this end and there. But I'ma do me. But I know I love y'all. And I wanna, you know what I mean? I want y'all to be successful in anything that you do. No matter what it is. Be successful in anything that you do. Love what you wanna do. Be the person that you wanna be. Don't be the person that somebody else is telling you that you have to be. Because that's what they seeing. Only you know what's good for you. That's all I gotta say. Love what you do. Don't be miserable. Just live life, bro. With that being said, I love y'all. I'm about to be. Oh yeah, once again, go follow those two people, please. Please. Shout out to my boy. Help them. You know what I'm saying? Spread some love. We're going to spread some love today. You know what I mean? Spread some love. I'm out of it.